election results are just out, and with me, the minister who's in charge of the Northeast area, Jitendra Singh. Congratulations, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
What would you say is the secret to the BJP's extraordinary performance in Tripura?
My first thought is that of a huge, huge vindication, huge, huge gratification. And to a great extent also, I take personal pleasure also, because as you said, as someone who's been assigned to look after the development of Northeast. And I think this also has vindicated the focus on development and the prioritization which was given to Northeast, and the revolutionary kind of development activity which happened, which had not been witnessed in the last 70 years because of the personal indulgence of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. At the same time, at the political level, I think this also marks the end of the politics of exploitation of the weaker sections, politics of appeasement, and above all, politics of winning elections by creating false illusions about BJP. BJP aayegi, halla ho jayega.
You mean the whole thing about BJP being Hindutva?
Including that, and then the kind of, you know, that ghost-like image of BJP that had been sought to be created. I think tremendous amount of effort and hard work has gone in the last 3-4 years to make people understand and be convinced that, look, we are one of you.
But
we are there totally, yeah, totally dedicated to serve you. The manner in Prime Minister Modi was repeatedly touring Northeast,
yeah,
the manner in which Amit Bhai Shah, soon after taking over as the president, declared that he would visit each of the 8 states and spend a night over there.
Yeah.
All this had never happened earlier.
Yeah. So one of the things, of course, you say that, you know, these fears, but do you think some of it didn't work in Meghalaya? Because in Meghalaya, the church, you know, this entire, and you all tried. You put KJ Alphonse, one of the first Christian faces, also in the area, but maybe that wasn't that effective.
No, I wouldn't totally agree with that, but I would also say that that narrative has also been sought to be created to a great extent. No, I'll tell you why. Just about 3 years back or so, when I was newly assigned this work, there were some Christian dominated areas. The moment I would reach, they would come to look me up and they would say, look here, hamein ye kaha gaya hai ki aap to conversion karne aaye hain. And some of the very learned among the Christian friends would say,
right.
And I would tell them, look here, if my organization or Sangathan had actually to do that, or was that the agenda, then this 130 crore people of this country would all have been converted into Hindus. So that's not the agenda. We are here focusing only on the aspirations of the 2018 Indian, which is that of Vikas, Vikas, Vikas.
And that's why you're looking at Kerala now. You're hopeful about Kerala.
I think the party under leadership of Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah has made a huge contribution of doing away with those demarcations of hinterland, mainland, as was being described. Now, Northeast is very much a part of mainland India as any other state. I mean, and that is evident from the manner in which you are covering us.
Yeah.
Because earlier on, elections happened in Northeast and nobody would even notice.
True. That's true.
So I think it's as much a coverage as an election in Gujarat or Punjab. So that itself is a huge contribution.
Thank you so much, sir.